Spooner Continent, there are evil sorcerers in this continent who use their powers for their own personal gain. But there are a group of people known as Sorcerer Hunters who hunt down these sorcerers and stop them from abusing their power.
It's alright, Kira. Didn't you know that my darling Carrot and your adorable sister are secretly engaged?
But engaged? And just who decided this?
Chocolate, cut it out!
Oh boy, here we go again.
They're as regular as clockwork.
Poor Marin. How long have you had to put up with those two and your brother now?
Oh, a while now. But I keep hoping Carrot will grow up eventually.
Huh?
With their boss, Big Momma, guiding them, they must find these evil sorcerers before they do any harm to the people of the Spooner Continent.
Gamaru is a fearsome dragon created by Mesitanian magic. If it reaches maturity, it could bring about untold calamity and disaster. The Gamaru is a creature born from the blackest of human passions. It feeds on the emotions of anger, fear, and pain. The pain of young women! Lord Regner has been abducting Kolanda's innocent young maidens and feeding them to the Gamaru.
He's feeding it women?!
Sorcerer Hunters, I am giving you the twin tasks of bringing this evil Lord Regner to justice and destroying the loathsome Gamaru. Will you do as I ask?
I shall stop this sorcerer. I swear I will!
So this is a fantasy comedy adventure anime created by Satoru Akahori, who worked on animes like Saber Marionette J and Abenobashi, and directed by Koichi Mashimo, who worked on animes like the Dot Hack anime series and the irresponsible Captain Taylor. This anime sees our heroes take on different villains in each episode, which I thought was sort of a plain storytelling for me. I mean, the only interesting part in this anime is when the main villain comes in, and I find the action in this anime fairly exciting. Comedy in this anime is a little bit repetitive.
Nurse me back down!
Plus, I wasn't really fond of the main characters. I mean, we have this one character named Carrot who's a total skirt chaser and is like totally useless until he absorbs evil energy and turns into a giant monster. Then there are the Misu sisters who at first were adorable, and then they turn into bondage queens when they transform and get into battle. And then there's Carrot's brother, who's a talisman wielder, and this muscle guy, which I forgot his name, who actually are totally useless. I mean, they barely do anything at all. The animation in this anime was done by Hisashi Abe and Koichi Goto, who worked on animes like Devil May Cry and Martian Successor Nadesco. The animation in this anime was pretty good, although sometimes I kind of felt that the screen looks a little dusty at times because it's an old 90s anime and all that. Although I do have a hard time figuring out which one of these animations is Hisashi Abe's design.
Once I've absorbed your magic energy.
What is that?
It's zoanthropy.
Carrot absorbs your evil magic, then uses the power to change himself into his alternate form.
The voice acting for both English and Japanese dub was just okay for me. But if I had to pick one, I would go with the Japanese dub, because when it comes to the English dub, I really wasn't fond of the female cast of voice actresses who played their characters. I mean, I just felt annoyed just listening to their voices.
So Darling has escaped his stone prison. What a pain!
He's getting pretty fired up, isn't he?
There's no time for subtleties. We'll have to...
Oh no! You don't mean that!
Yes, that's exactly what I mean.
The music in this anime was done by Kenji Kawai, who worked on animes like Rune Soldier and Ranma Half. The music in this anime feels like a mixture of modern-day music with fantasy sorcery music, which really works for this anime. And one thing's for sure, the opening and ending music really pumps up your blood for the adventure. In the end, Sorcerer Hunters may not have a lot of magic, but it still gives the fantasy fans a nice feeling of adventure. So, that's my review of Sorcerer Hunters. I give this anime a 3 out of 5. See ya!